problemas.
So, Robert, I interviewed Malik Scott yesterday. He's the coach of Deontay Wilder. And he told me that Wilder Joshua will always be a mega fight. Do you agree that it will always be?
So.
Why?
Because Wilder is a big fucking name, man. Look at the fight he just had against
Fury.
Fury, fucking fight of the year, man. I tell you, that's just fight of the year. Probably one of the best super heavyweight fights we've ever seen.
You know, five knockdown.
That shit was a good fight. You know, we haven't seen something like that in many years. What's another heavyweight fight that we could probably compare to that one?
One of the Ali fights
was
back in the day. Yeah.
Ali Frazier type of fight?
Yep.
Because I've probably never seen those fights, but Wilder Fury was fucking baddest fight, and you know, being dominated so bad in second fight, and then he comes and drops Fury, and you know, it was a fucking badass fight.
Okay.
I think him and Joshua would be a huge fight.
I think so too, and I think it would sell great. They're both built the same, they're both big punchers. They have a lot of knockouts.
Great
but
fight.
Bob Arum said that he would like to do Andy Ruiz against Tyson Fury. What do you think?
I think Tyson Fury is too big. Well, Andy Ruiz is, you know, his style could make it difficult.
He could chop him down to the body. He's quick, good footwork.
Fury's just too fucking big, man.
I think he could beat him. What do you think?
One thing is, Andrew's not gonna be afraid. He's gonna go out and fucking hurt somebody.
You know, Tyson Fury once said that he could beat Andy Ruiz with one hand tied behind his back.
That's not true.
So let's see him do it.
No,
you said you would do it.
Can't do that.
No, man. I think he just has to get back and believe in himself. Showcase his speed, you know. And
he's very talented. He's fought on the same cards with you.
He'll give anybody.
We've known Andy for many years. Yep.
He's got speed. He's strong. He's brave.
Fury's weakness is his body. Because when Wilder went to his body, he went out of his game plan.
That's where Andy
will focus on. And he can't do all those movements if you get hit to the body.
Andy's fast in there. Once he's inside, he's fast. You know what the
Yeah, he is. And it's gonna be, and if he fights on the inside, it's gonna be awkward for
because he's so low.
Because he's so big.
How is he gonna lean on him with 400 pounds?
Big,
you don't wanna lean on him.
Yeah, but that's a lot to go down because Andy's short.
If he leans on him, Andy will go under his feet, under his fucking,
throw his
feet,
or uppercut him, or something.
Uppercut him in the balls.
That's what I said. If he leans on him, if someone fights you dirty, fight dirty.
Uppercut him in the balls.
I think so. If he leans on him and fights dirty.
Yeah. Hit him in the knees.
I think Wilder is dangerous still with the right hand.
Yeah, from over. Yeah. Wilder's tough, man. Wilder's just a strong motherfucker.
It's a great fight. I hope it happens. Major pay-per-view.
Nice.
It's a good fight. And I like them both, you know. They're both very dedicated. Good people.
Joshua won the gold in your Olympics, right? 2012?
Yeah.
I know
Wilder,
he.
When did Wilder go to the Olympics?
'08,
right.
And he won the bronze. But he only had 30 amateur fights.
Yeah.
Started boxing at 21. That's very impressive.
That's impressive.
I remember Dominic Brazil fought Joshua.
Yeah.
I remember that because I went into the Olympic Village, and you had the little gym.
Olympics.
You had a really cool team with a lot of nice guys, like very friendly.
Yeah, great team.
Clarissa Shield was on your team. Clarissa
was.
JoJo. Jamel Herring.
Rasheed Warren.
Herring's a good dude, man.
Who was the alternates that year? Alternates, Caleb Plant? You don't remember?
There was two or three that went as sparring partners, but no, there wasn't. They could call themselves alternates.
Marcus Brown. He was there. And Terrell Goucher.
Yeah.